test media. So inside here, there's like a small pellet, and it goes into the water, and it's essentially like food for the bacteria to eat, and a dye. Like it goes, the water will go a yellow color, which you'll see in a minute. Now after, if there's E. coli in the water, it will start to eat the food that we give it, and the water will change color to a green color, and we can see the result based on that. So we're gonna take it now. The first thing you have to do is you have to sterilize your hands. So you take the hand sanitizer. The reason for that is we're trying to test the water quality, not what's on your hands. So you could, if you've been touching things, you've probably got bacteria on your hands already. So we're not interested in that. So you take the sample, you sterilize your hands with plenty of hand sanitizer. That's probably enough. Sorry, Mitch, you've got a lot. And, sorry, I'm just gonna put this down for a sec.
So this is essentially killing off the bacteria on our hands. Now we can take the sample. We wanna make sure it's accurate.
The next part is like the sample bag. So we can take this directly from like the tank or a spring or whatever the source might be. If it's really hard to kind of scoop the water, you can use a secondary container if necessary, like a water bottle. Okay, so these are disposable. You only use it once, and then you have to dispose of it after that. So, okay.
First thing I do
is you rip the top off here. So you see how I've taken that top off? It's inside, it's sterile, so that means that there's no bacteria or anything inside. There's two little white tabs here, and you pull them out to open it like this. So you never put your finger inside there. Okay. There's a little white pellet in here, and the purpose of that is if you're taking a sample from a chlorinated water source, like the pipe water, it does have some chlorine in there, and this neutralizes that, because we're looking for the bacteria that exist in there, so the chlorine would kill those bacteria. Next we have the dye media. I'm just gonna open it up here. They've made a new kind of design, which I find a bit annoying. It's a bit hard to rip open. Sometimes you kind of need scissors or something and try and find. Is there not scissors inside the bag over there? There's scissors in there? No. Jenny, you got Jenny's not there. For a knife, that's all right, got it. Yeah, so it's made a really tough plastic bag. I've changed it slightly, but what I've done is I've used the top of my So in your field kit, you should take some scissors or a small knife. Anything sharp will work. Now, it doesn't smell very good, by the way. You're introducing this kind of brown-looking substance into the water. So it's like, it smells a bit awful up here. Like a
piece of like tar or something on the road, kind of thing. So we tip some water in here now.
Yeah, tip the water in. And we're going to fill it to 100 mils. So up to the, there's a fill line here. Yep, keep going. Okay, stop.
So see how she's filled up to this black line here? Maybe it's a tiny drop more, but not too much. Yep, that's it. Perfect. Okay, so what I'm going to do now is you kind of spin it like this. And you see this, it's got this dye in the bottom here. And I'm just going to dissolve that in the water now. It can take up to, you know, 5 minutes kind of thing, but like depending on how warm the water is as well. It'll dissolve it, yeah. And see the water's changing a yellow colour. Now this is just for my water bottle, so I hope there's no E. coli in this one. But we can show you some that are actually contaminated as well. And we'll take some samples from them, from Boykin where we go tomorrow. So I see it's turning like, looks like urine a little bit now. Winnie's taken a lot of these samples actually, and they don't smell very good sometimes. So see, it's kind of disappearing, but it's transferring out to the... So see how it's, a lot of the dye is transferred over. I'm nearly done. When it comes a real dark colour like this, like you're nearly ready to process the sample. Okay, we'll just let it sit there for a sec. The next
step is our sample bag. So on this, you might be taking quite a few samples in one day. So you should write the date of the sample, what the water source is, and who's taking the sample as well. So I'm going to do that now. Okay, so I've written the sample details on there. Now this is also disposable, yeah, you just use it once. I'm gonna rip the top off, like that. And we open it like this, and then Estelle's gonna come and help with the next part over here. We're gonna transfer this water to this sample bag here.
So go ahead.
Yep. Open it up and
come over here so they can see. Yep.
Just unroll it like that. Now, don't put your fingers in it. Use the two little white things on this side. Yep.
Like this.
Yep, so she opens it up like that. Now, you're going to tip it inside here, slowly. Yeah, don't spill it. It's good to do with two people if you can. Yep, that's it. Yeah, keep going. That's all right. You gotta tip it all in. That's the way. Cool. Now I'm just gonna, you just massage that a little bit, just to make the water go down. Yeah, like that. See how it's going down into the bag now? It's gonna fill the different compartments. So next step, I'm going to just close it a little bit, just I don't want to spill it everywhere. Right. And you'll see these different, you're probably wondering why there's all these different compartments in here. So we have number one, number two, number three, number four, number five. But what does it all mean? So you'll see this fill line here, we have to transfer the water across to the fill lines. So I need some more water down in this one. Just gonna move it across. A bit more over here. Exactly. So, it's pretty good, just a bit more. All right, so what I'm gonna do now is just seal it so we don't lose any of the water. So I'll roll it down. Like that. And I'll use these two to seal it. Now in here, you see all the different volumes. We have a 10 milliliters, 30 milliliters, 56, that's the big one, 3, and 1 mil. So these different volumes, if there's E. coli in the water, they're not evenly distributed in the water sample. We take 100 mils and we're transferring it to here. So this one, the 56 mils, it's a bigger volume. So we're much more likely to find E. coli in that big volume of water than compared to the 1 mil. So this volume is 56 times greater than the one mil. So it means that the chances of finding it in this are quite high and much lower in the one mil volume. So after 24 to 36 hours, if there's E. coli, this will change it to green colour. And some of them might turn green, others might turn just stay this colour. And based on that, we can calculate the risk of drinking the water, essentially. So if there's E. coli in there, there's a calculation that's applied. And we just read the colour change of the chart. So it's a very simple test. Will, did you have anything to add on? Maybe you want to say something about how it's been used here?
Sure.
Yeah.
It's a very simple test.
Thank you, Tim. Just to emphasize on why we are doing water quality testing. The reason behind this is that people tend to think that a clear, crystal clear running water is safe for drinking. I'm straight on. Yeah. Even tank water, if you have to test a tank water, you're surprised to see that it's going to be very green, and it means that there is contamination. So our concern here is the quality of water that is provided for consumption. Like I said, water can be crystal clear, but is it safe, the quality of the water? That's the reason behind doing water testing, and it's very useful for city provincial health authority through WaterAid, especially with through team. We have ordered about 200 of those samples, and we have it here with us now. So in the event that there is a complaint from a community or a health facility, they report to us that there is a diarrhea outbreak or there is a foodborne disease outbreak, we go there to test the quality of water that they are drinking. And after 24 hours, we advise them the outcome so that the people know that diarrhea or typhoid or any other food and waterborne disease, it's from the water they're drinking. Mm-hmm. So yes, it's very useful and it's very handy and informative, like first all information that you relate to your people. And then you can wait for the other letter, like support to come, especially with the outbreaks of the diverse diseases. Yeah. Thank you.
Thanks, Queen.
Yeah, I
Kim.
Yes, go ahead.
Sorry, we haven't seen anything on the screen, or we haven't seen anything for probably about 15, 20 minutes now. And we've had this message. I don't think you can see
on that. Oh, sorry. The video just kept on turning off. I think there's something happening with the switches. So I'm sorry about that. Can you see it now?